Bo Nickel says he takes it as a compliment that fans were booing him at UFC 309. On the Ariel Helwani show, Bo said it was funny to hear the chants. It almost just made me laugh, because the crowd and the people that are doing that, I'm looking at, I'll just explain it this way. When you get disrespected by people that, in my opinion, have no idea what they're talking about, it's almost a compliment. To feel that from the crowd, it almost just made me laugh, because it's someone insulting you who has no idea what's going on. It's almost a compliment to me, because I feel like I controlled the fight, I did everything I needed to do, and I have a bunch of idiot drunk fans saying that they don't like the way it's going. I think that's actually probably a good thing. Bo, however, was disappointed with the commentary. He continued, "When I watched the fight back, something that was a little disappointing was the commentary, and just kind of hearing the way that they were looking at the fight. It made me feel like they didn't really know what was going on as much, because anybody that I've talked to, that are the people that I trust, that shoot straight with me, they're like, dude, you shut that guy out. Domination. It was a flawless victory." To hear things like DC say, oh, he's not ready for Khamzat, I think he was kind of trying to be respectful, but also trying to, like, maybe set me down a peg. It was just weird to hear. But I just feel like the people I know, who are in my corner, who would give me honest feedback, they're very happy with the victory. I was very happy with the victory, so that's what I really care about at the end of the day. But it was a little disappointing to hear some of those comments from the people that I respect a lot. Daniel Cormier responded to Bo. Here's what DC had to say on his YouTube channel today.
Bo Nickel is a bit upset with the commentary during the fight last week. This one kind of took me a little bit by surprise, because I do like Bo, and I do believe that at some point he's going to be a champion. I think that he's a respectful guy, so he's trying to say things in the nicest way that he possibly can, but I think he may have misunderstood what I'm trying to say. What I was more trying to say in this fight is, let's not rush him into fights with people that are much more experienced. That is how good he has done in that short period of time. You know what's the craziest thing? After this weekend, right after the fight, people called me and said I was a Bo apologist. I was being apologetic for his performance, almost making excuses for him. That's crazy, because it's odd that a fighter can interpret it so much different than other people in the world. I thought he did really good. I have no problem with Bo Nickel. I believe he's gonna be fine. I don't have a problem with the performance. I thought he fought really well. But there's room for improvement. Let's just take our time. We don't need to rush him. That's all I'm saying.
Francis Ngannou did not enjoy watching Mike Tyson box Jake Paul. Speaking to TMZ Sports, Francis said, "It just hurt me to see Mike there in that situation. Like, knowing Mike, what he can do, and see him in there with Jake Paul. And Jake Paul, like, hey man, like, that sight just hurt me. Although you have to give it to Mike, man. This is 58-year-old Mike Tyson that's been doing the sport since 12 years old, I believe. And to still be able to stand up on his own, at this age, I think it's impressive. Stand up against a young 27-year-old guy, even though I would say he wouldn't be at that level, there wasn't much of a threat for Mike. You have to give it up to him." Justin Gaethje and Diego Lopez hit the punching machine. Diego posted this footage to his Instagram story. Michael Chandler says he was in the worst pain of his career after the fight against Charles Oliveira. On Bussin' with the Boys, Chandler claims he peed blood during the post-fight drug test.
I had a phenomenal training camp. We went to war. We did our thing. Body, the most pain I've ever been in my entire life. Like, the most injuries I've ever had in a fight, for sure.
Yeah.
You know, peed blood, inflammation all over. My whole body's swollen. I feel like, you know,
he
my legs.
Blood?
Yeah.
What's like, that? Was it like a dense color of blood, or was it like a light pain?
The first one was very light, which was in my drug test. New York drug tested me before the fight and then after the fight.
Just in case.
Test positive. Yeah.
I tested positive for blood.
For being a bad
sure.
For savagery.
Tested positive for
got that dog in him.
Going nuts. But yeah, so they had like a light tint, and then the second one was like beet looking juice. It was dark.
God, did it hurt?
No.
Really?
I don't. Well,
like, what is? What
also,
is,
my whole body hurt too. So at that point, you know.
Shavkat Rakhmonov spars with Nazardin Imavov ahead of his upcoming fight against Ian Garry at UFC 310. Ray Longo discusses the call he got from Chris Weidman, letting him know that Eric Anders pulled out of their fight last minute at UFC 309.
I love you too, man. I'm really sorry about what happened with Chris Weidman. I mean, my
gosh.
I got to tell you, man, I was getting ready to, you know, go get him to get on the bus. And when he called, I swear I was praying that he was bullshitting. Like, I was like, don't, I'm already nervous. Don't do this. And he's like, no, it's true. And I said, all right, let me come over there. And then we went down there. And I mean, I just actually packed up and kind of went home. I was like, I don't even know what I just did. Thank God we went to the club. I thought I was rented a room in Manhattan and was hanging out for a while. It was like bizarre. But yeah, unfortunately, I hope Eric Anders is all right. You know how that goes.
Michael Bisping thinks that Michael Chandler is his own worst enemy. Bisping says Chandler needs to slow it down, be more disciplined in fights, and follow a game plan.
I got to be careful because I spoke to Michael Chandler. We did an interview last week, and I always leave my time talking to Michael Chandler thinking the same thing. Wow, what a class act. Yeah. What a nice guy. So much respect for him, you know. But having said that, I'm about to talk a bunch of shit because you're absolutely right. It's all well and good being exciting. Any aggressive guy off the street, wannabe bad guy, tough guy, thug, you know, they can all be exciting and swing crazily. But what separates you from being a meathead fighter and being world class is not only having discipline and a work ethic and the ability to push through those hard training camps, but staying focused and disciplined and following a game plan and not overcommitting to shots and not swinging like a wild man so much so that you fall on the floor. And he's got to look at that going forward because, yes, he's brilliant. And he's entertaining, and the crowd are losing its mind. And yeah, it was so impressive that after taking a tough beating, still to turn it all around and almost get a stoppage in the final round, and to climb to his feet and put on a show and jump to his back and, you know, thrilling the audiences. It's amazing. And for that, I got so much respect. But he's kind of his own worst enemy because he's got all the attributes that you want, but he's got to control this.
Yep.
I say it all the time. It's a broken record. That's why I became the champ when I was almost 40 myself, because finally I worked with a good coach, Jason Perillo, who worked on this side of things. You've got to slow it down. You've got to be disciplined. You've got to follow a game plan. You've got to respect your opponent and be a thinker. You have to think. The best fighters are the best thinkers. That's why John Jones right now is probably sitting at home in Albuquerque laughing his head off because he knows what he's doing. He's messing with all of us because he's a great thinker and he's manipulating everybody. He's playing us all like a little violin, right? And that's what you got to do. You've got to think when you're in there. And yep. Chandler doesn't seem to think.
Chael Sonnen shares a concern he has for Tom Aspinall regarding the matchup against John Jones. Speaking to Submission Radio, Chael said, "One thing that worries me about Aspinall is what other people praise him for, which is he's only been out of the first round one time. People praise him for that. He had to go almost 7 minutes in to finish Andre Arlovsky. I don't like that. I think that's a problem. You're going to end up third, fourth, and fifth round if you're going to find a way to get the jump on John Jones. Nobody's doing it fast, and I think that's the one thing that John has. He's tough, he can regroup, he shows up in great shape regardless of his lifestyle. I've never seen anyone outcondition him. I just think it's relevant. I'm going to plant that seed right now." After watching Michael Chandler's loss to Charles Oliveira, Renato Moicano does not believe that Chandler is at the UFC level. Renato says he will beat the shit out of Chandler if they ever fight because he doesn't have the skills. Be sure to go check out the latest episode of the Show Me the Money podcast. Links in the description.
First of all, before that,
okay,
we all can acknowledge that Michael Chandler is not UFC level. Can we talk about that, or is too
what
soon?
Does that even mean, though? He's definitely UFC level. He might not be top.
UFC level? The guy, like UFC top contender level? How many wins he has?
He starched Dan Hooker in the first round.
Brother, you're talking about the turtle in a tree? Michael Chandler, he has knockout power and two good shots. He does that all the time. He starts and he throws big punches. If he doesn't land, he walks backwards. You know, and I know he's a wrestler and all that, but Charles was taking him down easy on the fight, you know? And he's not explosive. Charles is a
high level, you know?
Charles is high level, but he's not well known by his wrestling.
I was surprised how easy to take
He was not well known by his wrestling. So now I think we have seen enough to tell Michael Chandler is a product of media, my brother. He sells the image, the hard work. You know,
guys never come to the party again. Sorry, all the listening.
Michael Chandler is not coming. I'm not even hating the guy.
He's just speaking his truth. He's not here.
Yeah, I'm not hating. I'm not hating him. We are competitors on the same division. One day he can prove me wrong and knock me out. But guess what? I'm gonna beat the shit of Michael Chandler if we fight. Because you know what? He doesn't have the skills.
Tom Aspinall reveals he is now in negotiations with the UFC to fight John Jones. Tom says he doesn't know the date just yet, but he's ready to go.
My question, champ, when do you see your next fight happening? Brackets, we all know from that smile that it has to be John Jones. Please reply, thanks a lot.
Yeah, we're in negotiations right now, is the honest answer. So we don't know when the fight is gonna be. But I'll be ready to go whenever. I'm back in the gym now. I'm back in the gym training, as always, and I'll be ready to fight when they let me know. Until then, I'll be improving. I'll be getting better. So no great rush on that. Obviously, I want to fight as soon as possible, but right now, we're just waiting for a date. That's it.
And that's going to wrap it up for the news. Thanks for watching. For daily MMA news and content, subscribe to Full Mount MMA and click the bell icon to be notified when we post videos. Here are the three top comments from last video. The first one says, Bo is overrated. Boy was scared to attempt a takedown on Paul Craig. The second one says, so basically, Bo is bent out of shape that DC is stating the obvious. Nichols showed that he has a long way to go, with both his skills and his ego. And the final one's from the guy 707. It says, Ian Garry confessing his desire to sit in a dark corner and watch Buckley KO Covington. Just his style. Those were the three top comments from last video. If you want to be featured in the next one, all you have to do is comment down below. And if you missed yesterday's news, click the video on screen right now to get caught up.